Bobby get dragged from the stage, handcuffed and caged for cursing and spitting that 5-0. I'm on a mission to find folks to victimize. Say the masochist wishing to die slow. Listen to my throes, the torturous. I'll see to it, you're finished. Leave your unfortunate seeds in an orphanage. Even if your image dictates, you love the way it dictates, you'll get tossed from a big stage. Put your hands down, dick face. I didn't tell you to raise them. I started underground and then I fell through the basement. Misplaced, so like I had to sell it to Satan. In the midst of hellish arrangement, try to tell him to change it. So make a relevant statement, say that you sell your tape, and say that your 12-inch plate on your favorite Wellington station. I'm waiting for celebrating your folded career over a beer. I know where you live, wake up and smell the fragrance. Heathenous,
creatinous,
reasonless,
savages,
treasonous, activists,
greedy and ravenous.
We face off,
wage war,
and beat up our pacifists.
He's the compassionless,
and he's the antagonist.
Yo, who the fuck else you know that I run up on your block strip like an insane Christopher Columbus and start conquering shit? Self-titles that nigga, and he ain't playing dog. I thought I told you that we blazing niggas till they skin fall off. Roll out the red carpet and make you blend in with it. And that place that you was born from, I've been up in it. Masterpiece versus everything that I done dope. Fuck puffing on cigars, I'll blow donut holes with gun smoke. I don't want your demo rappers, we extort them. You ain't going platinum, nigga, you gon' be post-mortem. Slice the throat to your whole clique till my palms hurt, and it'll be more rednecks than a Willie Nelson concert. Better believe me, motherfucker, we ain't nice dogs. We know the real and pull your car like fake IDs at nightclubs. Lift up that skirt and see just what type of guy you are. Throw you off the fucking roof and see just how fly you are.
Heathenous,
creatinous,
reasonless,
savages,
treasonous, activists,
greedy and ravenous.
We face off,
wage war,
and beat up our pacifists.
He's the compassionless,
and he's the antagonist.
I'm trying to put Diablo on you.
I should never be fooled with my devilish music. We'll put a spell on you, stupid. Whoever you're cool with will forever be losers. I'll hit you so hard your kids will inherit the bruises. Malevolent mood shifts attached to Satan, and a sick fascination with Patrick Bateman. Then disguise the crimes from the pigs at the station. They missed that arraignment cause I slipped past probation.
And ain't shit changed, Lou. We two are the fucking illest niggas. The type of cats that will randomly murder serial killers. I'm an angry person that'll hang you from a dangling curtain for certain. I'm like Satan lurking through paintings and serpents. An ill contortionist, twist your body and crack limbs, and you can see what it's like to walk forward but face backwards. My dick get hard when I pull the rifle and spray shots and leave your whole crew shaking worse than Michael J. Fox.
Heathenous,
creatinous,
reasonless,
savages,
treasonous, activists,
greedy and ravenous.
We face off,
wage war,
and beat up our pacifists.
He's the compassionless,
and he's the antagonist.
Heathenous, creatinous,
reasonless,
savages,
treasonous, activists,
greedy and ravenous.
We face off,
wage war,
and beat up our pacifists.
He's the compassionless,
and he's the antagonist.
Diablo!
On this fucking stage. I'm scared, woo! God damn it.
Yeah.
Does anybody out in this audience like to drink?
You got any? What the fuck kind of question is that? We at college, son.
Because I think there are a lot of thirsty motherfuckers in this crowd.
That's what I think. Let me hear you.
Come on, check this out. Listen, all this shit y'all talking ain't got no facts. Who passed the 40 around and we'll see who got some skills. I mean, yeah. If you got them, you got them. And if you
don't, get them. Yeah, word is bomb.
Before setting it on. Fresh from a car, running from a bar tab, driving drunk with car lag, in need of a bath bag. I left my smart hat on the hard path to recovery, with a hangover hovering. I took a bath in the bubbly, I woke up in the trash, cold clutching a flask, with the wino asking for some from me, but there's no stuff in my stash. I'm so stuck in the glass, but insist on throwing rolling rocks. Shades drawn, doors closed and locked, hoping no one knocks. I'm in a lonely spot, nowhere, and I want some stoly shots, like I don't care if my AA's fine.
to nose or not. I spend a week soaking scotch on Venice Beach with the vagrants. Then I'm leaving for Vegas, but I'm penny free and owe a lot of dough to spot my landlord and old lady Licks. It's like I said, she likes to collect, she don't babysit. I'm the lush president of the wino section. Since you find no lessons in this lonely life, it's like
shorty, let me tell you about my own advice.
I've been at war with Lady Licks and can't find no weapons or find protection on my coldest nights. It's like,
shorty, let me tell you about my only vice.
So basically, my drinking schedule was 8 to 3, but wait and see, I bet you I can make the rate increase until I start spraying my vomit on my old navy fleece. So saith the logic, so say the sheep. My next commandment, to drink a case of peace at least to set the standard. A bunch of drunks are dead from cancer. Leave your 12 steps abandoned on the way to the bar. A convoy that's on joy juice racing their cars. Drinking rain from a jar that's moonshine to the layman in bars. And soon I'm hearing angels with harps. Perhaps it's beeping horns and I'm crossing lanes in my car. And sleeping on a job, I made it so far. I'm thinking, ain't this bizarre? It's kind of freezing. Trying to find the reason when I realized my gates were ajar. I took the Nestle plunge straight to the tar but never jumped. Then I awoke in a pool of puke where I had left my lunch. I'm the lush president of the wino section. Since you find no lessons in this lonely life, it's like,
shorty, let me tell you about my only vice.
I've been at war with Lady Licks and can't find no weapons or find protection on my coldest nights. It's like,
shorty, let me tell you about my only vice.
I was born with beer kegs and cottage domes and Molotov mixtures. Fist up, breaking bottles off niggas. Make escape doing a 100-yard dash. Coming from a car crash, that's what I call a running bar tab. Back to the lab when an undercover car passed after my ass. Dropped to my knees and my hands in the grass. A straight shot to the trees beside my door, but I'd forgotten my keys. Plus I had too much brandy to last, so I hopped to my feet. My hands are both clasped, stopping the stream. If I puke, the cop will probably see. But he was watching me flee on wobbly feet. At least that's what I'm thinking. That's when he tackled me, stagnant and stinking. I said, no way, Oscar, I haven't been drinking. Then he said, you're under arrest, kid, and we're going back to the precinct.
Pip. Best of 40, cause my mother's not looking.
I'm the lush president of the wino section. Since you find no lessons in this lonely life, it's like,
shorty, let me tell you about my only vice.
I've been at war with Lady Licks and can't find no weapons or find protection on my coldest nights.
Shorty,
it's like,
let me tell you about my only vice.
Ready for a clinic. And I thought you'd watch my lady while I'm gone, dude.
Yo, come on, Lou, of course that's cool. You're my fucking man, my fam. I mean, damn, I don't got no other plans. We can rent some Blockbuster, catch a movie or two. Yo, but I'ma have to leave at home if there's some hoochie to screw.
Cool shit, yeah, this booty for you? Handle yours, hit the bed. I ain't trying to cock block if you're getting head. Lick and spread that chicken stead. But if not, you gotta watch my baby then. Cause most of my lady's friends are chicken heads.
Yeah, that's understandable. Broads can be real influential, and keeping a clean slate is instrumental in relationships potential. I run into the store, front of dough if she's low, and try to keep her from running with clubbing hoes.
Word, I knew there was a reason you're my brother, yo.
Of course, Lou, you're blood from another mother, no other, bro.
Hey, yo, App, what up? It's Lou. My bus is stuck in Butte. I'm glad I trusted you to watch my lovely Lou. Hey, yo, y'all found some
stuff to do?
Word up, we just bugging, dude. Trying to watch this flick. You wanna talk to your chick? Oh, hold up, she just went into the bathroom sick. See, we was drinking and shit, and now we're chilling on the couch. We was thinking of going out with the side of the lounge in the house.
Lounge in the house? Bouncing me out? What you mean she's sick? Yo, who the fuck you think you drinking with? You're supposed to be overseeing shit. It sounds like a more health taking
look. Yo, you're breaking up, Lou, and you're tripping like I'm tricking with your chick. Stop being a dick, acting like we're feeding the stick. Yo, fuck it, don't pick it up. Lou's just being a jerk and going berserk. He's probably just stressed from all the work. Let's relax, sure we can cuddle. There's nothing wrong with that. You can lay across the couch and put your head on my lap. Oh, what up, B?
Don't what up me, you fucking asshole. I dropped out of my tour and had to duck my last show. What's going on with you and my girl? Slutty asshole, you fucking her? What, you trying to ruin my world?
Yo, first of all, kid, take that fucking tone out your voice. We boys, but what your girl does is really her choice. Now she's sitting lonely at home while you're doing your shows. Besides, son, I thought it was bros before hoes.
So if your clothes come off while you're chilling with my sweet thing, I'm supposed to let her share her G-string? I'ma take that anniversary ring right back to Zales. Ask the sales girl to take back the pearls. Smack the curls off my lady's head and kill you for your treachery. You said you were my best friend, instead you got the best of me.
Yo, Lou, this shit is hectic, B. I'm really not the enemy. It takes two to tango and we share the same energy. One night over some Hennessy, we started messing sexually and, well, now we're dealing with an unexpected pregnancy.
Yo, man, just calm down, dog.
Fucking bitch!
Nah, what the... Dude, just fucking take a breath,
she
yo.
She fucking left me with one of my own friends,
I know,
man.
I know, but just fucking try to chill, yo. Get a grip on things.
I can't believe this shit is happening to me.
Yeah, you know what, yo? There's other fish in the sea, man.
What?
There's other motherfucking bitches out there.
What? Fuck that, man. No.
Nah.
I'll tell you what we're gonna do, man. I'll tell you what we're gonna do.
First and foremost, I gotta figure out what hurts him more most. Before we show up at this nigga's house, we can rip him out the driver's seat, pin him down, grab the hag and jam a rag in her mouth, wrap some string around her wrist and tie her feet. You guys toss her in the back of the van, I'll be smacking a man with the back of my hand, but that's just half of the plan. I can't believe this fucking snake used to pass as my fam. Come up and shake my hand like it wasn't fate. Ram, you take the van to my cousin's place in the countryside. Self and Christian, I want you guys to help me lump this guy. We'll beat his ass within a half an inch of his life and fuck him up just enough to make his mother cry. Then we'll leave the punk beside town square, tied to a street pole, so people see his lump behind our bed. We'll come and ride out where the slutty flirt lays too, strip her down to a birthday suit. Last but not least, drive inside a farm with cows, chilling by the barn and dump her where the heifers squirt their poop. You got it?
Yo, yo, grab his fucking arms, man. Yo,
fuck
get
off.
Get
fucking ready to shut that bitch the fuck up.
Come on, get the fuck off. Yeah, man.
Let's fuck this nigga up, man. Fucking bitch.
All right.
I'm gonna hit you.
Yo, all right, enough, man.
Well, fuck that.
Yo,
fuck that
chill.
Shit.
Holy shit, dude, he's bleeding a lot. I ain't no doctor, but he ain't moving. I can't tell if he's breathing or not.
Yo, never mind. Y'all need to just stop and check his signs. Feel his neck and find his pulse. If he dies, we'll get in time.
Dies? What? We're only supposed
yo,
to scare
shut
him.
The fuck up.
The cops are gonna bust this man. His family knows the parents. God, there's no pulse, there's no repairing. This nigga's dead. I know his mother, too. That bitch is overbearing. I need a cigarette.
Man, take some fucking Nicorette, Lou. We killed the guy.
Yo, stop saying that. Maybe he's still alive.
If someone tries CPR, he'll survive.
If he's got any blood that's still inside.
After you shut up, I think I see a car.
What do we do?
We'll get some plastic bags and duct tape. Cut him up, package him, dig a hole and leave this faggot upstairs.
Yeah, that's just great, we're all gonna end up in a cell.
Or in a chair, you whiny bitch, but you'll love it in hell.
Come on, you assholes, this isn't helping. Christ, he fucking stinks, he dumped on himself. This nigga smells.
That's what happens when you split your melon. Give me the switchblade from the trunk. We'll make two stiffs fit as well in a ditch made for just one.
We're fucking triple felons.
Quit your yelling, help me wrap the arms up. We gotta get this job done before any more cars come. We'll go meet up with our son and take care of the bitch. Gift wrapped in a cinch sack and dump the pair in a ditch.
Dispatch, this is car 51. Possible 187 suspects loaded back, shaped like body parts in a trunk.
Hey, what's the fucking cops?
I told you assholes, a car's gonna come.
Hey, sure it looks now. Let's go before they start with the gun.
This is car 51 requesting backup. We are in pursuit of three suspects in a gold Honda Accord. BA license plate, Bravo, David, Sally, 8128. Possible 187, repeat. Possible 187 requesting backup.
Surrounded, but the SWAT team's around it, and you're going downtown, kid.
Sit down, bitch, we ain't going no place.
those sirens down.
Oh, baby. Oh, no. Baby. Oh, baby. Oh, no. Baby. Oh, no. Oh, baby. Oh, no. Baby. Oh, no.
I just big time in love. And then 4 months down the road, the idiot here kicks in. And I ask about the ex-boyfriend, which, as we all know, is a really dumb move. But you know how it is. You don't want to know, but you just have to know, right? Stupid guy bullshit.
Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls. In this corner, quivering in the white trunks, we have the unsuspecting boyfriend. Facing up to the champion, his well-seasoned girlfriend. The three knockdown rules in full effect.
That's the sound of curiosity peeking like cops to pat you down. Boyfriend's probably seeking the dirt on his skirt as if he's deep in the earth. Like who had reached in the shirt and who was sleeping with her. But hey, she's only human and probably only doing the dude who she loves most, so you know who she's screwing. But while you lying there spooning, assuming life is just all good, you inadvertently missed the signs of the falsehood. Living life in a small hood, you probably collide with lots of the guys who used to climb on top of your wives. So it's not a surprise you're asking the stupidest questions. Who is the best in the sack and how many dudes have you slept with? But the chances, you didn't want them answers and can't live with it. You used to be just a dancer, making the fast tips you would stuff a pants with. And fast as math transit, she thought you were romances.
I'm so glad we met, hey shorty.
Come on girl, try to be patient, I know I'm a pain in the
but your
ass.
Your ex-boyfriend has me stressed, back off dude.
And all of this ex stuff should just remain in the past.
No, we can't get married yet.
It isn't just that it's greener, it's also the length of the grass.
But somehow you keep on running to me.
And we keep living in fear of the idiot
right
gear.
About this time,
most of y'all are just wishing that this was fiction. Or itching to ask your chick if your dick is in a depiction. Or fitting inside a stitching when you're sewing it up. And to think that most of this stuff is just over a fuck. I know what you're thinking, we've all grown up with women. And living without them seems like it's harder than living with them. But if you hit them, you probably end up living in prison, fellas. Then you'll be someone's bitch, I hope your girlfriend isn't jealous. This Cinderella shit's totally irrelevant. You'll never get a girl older than seven that's been celibate. Cause every chick has been around the block with a guy at 10. And guys are sensitive, it's better that you lie to them. Even the violent man who drops up in street clothes with stilettos and heat, know they got delicate egos. If she chose to tell you all the persons with whom she put in work in the womb, it would burst your balloon.
I'm so glad we met, hey shorty.
Come on girl, try to be patient, I know I'm a pain in the
but your
ass.
Ex-boyfriend has me stressed, back off dude.
And all of this ex stuff should just remain in the past.
No, we can't get married yet.
It isn't just that it's greener, it's also the length of the grass.
But somehow you keep on running to me.
And we keep living in fear of the idiot.
Looking at your sweetest snapshot,
that's when you start to wonder about the backdrop of other lovers. When you discover another flick of a hidden up under there, dressed in summer wear with an ex giving a bunny ass. And no one wants to share the chick with the last guy to get rid of the bad vibes. You figure you'd ask why. Her past life still chilling in the picture frame. She'd probably forget his name if the dick's the same, which is lame. But for some dumb reason, the last bum seeps into your dreams and you become unseasoned. To one evening, you build up the heart to ask her.
Disaster.
With your lungs breathing hard as asthma. And after she breaks down and tells you the truth, it leads to a fight and she's yelling at you. And I'm convinced that this being your queen's only king you miss.
See, Lou is right.
Ignorance is bliss.
I'm so glad we met, hey shorty.
Come on, girl, try to be patient. I know I'm a pain in the
but
ass.
Your ex-boyfriend has me stressed.
Back off, dude. And all of the sex stuff should just remain in the past.
No, we can't get married yet.
It isn't just that it's greener, it's also the length of the grass.
But somehow you keep on running to me. Oh, what's a guy to do?
Now listen to me, Bobby. You're all fucking idiots. How do you like them apples?
You know, I don't think we need to do the thing where we tell each other everything.
We were a couple young cats who made rap but did no new things.
till we pulled ourselves up by our Timbo bootstrings. Now introducing to unrelated kinfolk who sing and rap like it's a family group thing. Jay's been producing tracks so real, they're more packed with feeling than a menstrual mood swing. Lou brings to the table sprinkles of fable and raw raps from meals on instrumentals you drink. While you blink your eyes, we mingle by single file and put our music in the aisles and put the mom and pop shop kids in smiles with our infantile humor and a vintage style. Folks in denial, they change their tune, but not half as much as JJ and Lou. How could something already made great improve? We never came late to school, but may break the rules. I took the hate that fueled my first CD and made a trade for tools I used to improve diversity. So many MCs play the fool perfectly and prefer to be untrained in school purposely. Learn from me, take control of your true means. A vocalist whose dreams can open a new scene. Lewis and Jay didn't just turn over a new leaf. This music we made is growing a few trees.
What's on the menu for today, Jay?
How about grade A music from a group in its heyday?
JJ, Lewis, and Dan D are using these plant seeds to grow fresh music the fans need.
Is there a chance we find defeat?
Never that.
Better rhymes and beats mean what?
We make better tracks.
We let the stats do the chit-chat. Made 13 straight grades so you would never have to skip tracks.
Is this the start of something beautiful? Or have I missed the mark and we're still having fun as usual? A bit of both. I'm not into written notes, hitting notes, or spitting flows. It's just as musical. What's the funeral for? As if every tune that's recorded was scored in a room at a morgue. You would have thought there hasn't been a suitable song or a dude who performed well since 92 or before. But it's 2 in the morning and I'm still awake, doing some yawning with my head on a song before the pillowcase. How many groups that conform will it take to fill your crate up with the dead weight until it breaks? Rap has been running still in place for 20 years. Children playing villain games in their older brother's gear. How someone wearing a silly clown suit from the laundry ever became cool is beyond me. And what's more, we got used to believing that 2 of 15 hits constitutes an achievement. Nobody lets one rapper through the MC, and you get crammed with so many guests there's no room for the breathing. But it's only the best, Jay and I are feeding them, cause most of you left hot out for mild and medium. That's why we're teaching them to shine the tedium and put a higher premium on fine ingredients.
I dedicate this to brag.
Fucking good. And I never have been.
Just cause Jay and I got
citizens. Heaven sent me into a saloon full of bad medicine. Jay Jettison beats through the board. Lay in time, reach through the chords like a modern day Edison who had antennas in his own Frankenstein. It made a rhyme way better than the rest of the rap rejects. Three steps ahead of the pack and destined to have respect for incredible raps and tight shows. Two devilish cats you might know for crafting more unforgettable tracks for the brats and psycho. They thought he was a psycho cause he liked flows in a 3-4 and writes prose with his eyes closed while he drives home on a detour. Scourge of the police force on a run with a cold 12 pack. Stupid and drunk and doing 101 with no belt strap. The ruinous one, Lewis has come. Tell that to our governor. I've taken a track to Hades and back and hell had to turn the oven off. Truth is they hated their rap. Music has greater impact on views than the mistruths on the evening news. So the devil's taking it back.
You ever notice how your life is rolling by you? It isn't what it seems. I wrote this down so you would know that I knew. This is just a dream. It's the fictitious stuff you see as voyeurs. The same tricks that make us believe in lawyers. They sell the same lies to the girls and boys for your whole life, telling you the world's your oyster. If that's the case, I'm allergic to seafood. Castaway, and that's what they serve when they feed you. So you're covered in goiters, a loving and joyous. Smooth the waistline in 8 days' time you see through. Who's to say it'll improve today? You can lose some weight you didn't want to lose your way. And life is one of those books where you choose your fate. So you can hang yourself, but I bet the noose would break. Hey, I guess you gotta try to laugh at it. Cause mathematically it's half tragic and half havoc. Dagnabbit, who would've ever thought I'd get the short straw out of life if I grabbed at it? I'm on a path padded down by sore feet. Feeling like the last cat in town with dogs eat. King of the fools on a short leash. I used to laugh at the clowns who had on the crown before me. Well, now I'm chuckling at my own expense. It doesn't cost me the bucks that I've been known to spend on what a simple cup of coffee and donut can. It's like save the children, but for grown-up men, friends. I'm in a zen place, sporting a gent's face. Though I'm a chump, I'm over the hump like Wednesdays. I don't go for most of the junk, my friends say. I let it roll over my cold shoulder like Ben Gay. That's the best way to treat disaster. Cause if you let regret stay, it eats you faster than your breastplate shakes when you breathe with asthma. The death may take me to greener pastures. I need a pastor, a priest, a rabbi, and a shaman to ask or beseech the bad guy to blame for the fact that I lead a sad life. Ashamed to pack up and leave my campsite. You gotta find a way to laugh, right? When I'm practically pissing my pants over this damn ride. And I don't wanna end up missing the chance for me to grab my slice from the dish in advance. Man, I spent a lot of time listening to cans instead of opening the lid on the cans. If I put half my time spent on bitching and rants into a plan, I could slip from the trance. But I guess this is the dance of life I lead. My lawn isn't of grass, it's thigh-high weeds. My wife lives with my man beside my street. So I see her kiss him again every time I leave. And I'm just trying to find my speed. Fucking Jiminy Crickets, I got another cop giving me tickets. What would my life be if it didn't seem wicked? Even my landlord said she'd love to get me evicted. That's cold, I'd expect a mother to stick with. Home struggling nitwit, son who's a misfit. Asshole, but nothing can fix it. I'd put my trust in Lady Luck if she wasn't sadistic. But I've had so little success, I'm elated at the prospect of rest and being cremated. And right now, I'm thinking of putting this mic down. Cause being dead is even better than being hated. This ain't quite how I was picturing my career. They're sticking it in my rear, these are not my terms. But I figured I'm in the clear since they got me burned. Until the funeral director went and dropped my urn. Well, I guess you gotta learn to laugh at it. When you're the brunt of your own joke, it doesn't seem as tragic. Take it from someone who knows, folks. There isn't a mathematic pattern for outrunning your own woes. Well, so goes your role at the zoo, but it still isn't what it seems.
That's why I wrote this down so you would know that I knew this is just a dream.